The usual one.
Inversion,
yeah. It's strange in that it wasn't done before, because it's much simpler design.
Fantastic question, and I'll give you a very simple answer to that. The point is that it has been done before in a slightly different way, and we have done it in a slightly different way. Let me explain you where is that change. We are not putting magnets just on the blade. See, there are two ways to magnetize a blade. Yes? Please understand a very trick also. There is a slight trick here. But people don't understand this much actually. This is the axis. You don't have to put the magnets just here only and stick it. If you look at this view, and suppose it's a three-blade machine, and this is the axis. Do you agree that the magnets can be put here also?
Yes.
It doesn't matter, because the orientation of the radial orientation of the blades has not to be synchronous with the orientation of the magnets, because the magnets have to turn around the coil which they are. But what change we are making is, we are making this blade of a ferro material, or making a normal blade by CAD-CAM and then additive manufacturing, and then removing the material and putting iron fillings in it, and then magnetizing them. So basically, the blade itself becomes the magnet. You see? So you lose to you the extra mass is not there. You are a mechanical engineer. You can think there are 100 ways. You can change the magnetism of the blades by the Curie point and temperature. You can change the magnetism by the, there are endless ways. If you have iron filling, you can have a ferromagnetic fluid, you can have plasma. I mean, I can give you 100 different materials. You know more than me on this. I'm not a material person. But there are 100 different ways I'm giving you the idea. Remember one thing. If you have anything in porous form or in microscopic form, you always have more control over the system. You agree to that? Yeah, you agree. So you have more control because you're not filling iron fillings. You can fill iron fillings with some more density, you can choose some other material, you can fill them with a gel, you can fill them with some gel so that when the windmill is going round fast, they will go towards the end. And omega will remain the same. When r will increase, do you agree the relative motion omega r will increase? Yes. So now I am bright. Thank you so much for such a bright question. Let's give him a clap.